With the following images, I present a selection of deities which the visitor will find in the Buddhist monasteries of Sri Lanka. Sculptures and paintings of gods are quite common in all Buddhist countries of Asia. In Sri Lanka, you hear and read the slogan Buddha Saranai Devi Pihitai. Devi Pihitai means that gods are worshipped for many reasons. They protect and help the people. Buddha Saranai means take refuge to the Buddha and follow and practice the moral rules that the Buddha proclaimed. There is no contradiction in this. Also, the list of gods is not complete. The most important deities are included in this video. Many of the deities, like Vishnu, Brahma, Ganesh, etc., are known from India. Probably they were introduced by the Brahmins, who managed the court of the Hindu kings, which ruled the island for a while. As far as the iconographic details of the deities are already published, they are not repeated here. The most important deity at the southwest coast is Kataragama. His color is red, he has four arms, his vehicle is the peacock, and he wears the two emblems, axe and cock, in two of his hands. These sculptures are about 2 or 3 meters high and all located around Matara. Matara is the only larger city in the south. The sculptures are placed together with Vishnu next to the sculpture of Buddha Gautama. In this example, Kataragama is part of the ornamental arch, also called Makara Torana, which decorates the entrance to the sanctuary with the Buddha sculpture. Godskanda was introduced from India. He is worshipped mainly around Kandy, but also in Colombo and southwards. Also, his color is red and his vehicle is the peacock. His image differs significantly from that of Kataragama. He has 12 arms and 6 faces. Nevertheless, it can be observed that the Kataragama cult in the southwest is to be replaced by that of Skanda. This is a rare and early example from a 19th century mural of Skanda around Galle. This painting is inside a small temple next to the sanctuary. Surprisingly, there is also a sculpture of Kataragama in the same room. At the entrance, both names are announced. This modern painting of Skanda I came across in Maharagama. This is a part of Colombo. All murals at this monastery remind of the theater style, which was very popular during the first decades of the 20th century. Besides Kataragama or Skanda, God Vishnu is the second important god who is worshipped in Sri Lanka. Like Kataragama, he is often placed inside of the inner chamber next to the sculpture of the Buddha. If there are shrines of gods at the monastery, the shrine of Vishnu is on one side of the sanctuary and Kataragama or Skanda on the other side. Vishnu is from Indian origin. His statue or shrine is always marked with the color blue. He has four arms, a shell in one hand and a discus in the second. His vehicle is the bird Garuda. This painting is an early representation of Vishnu, which I discovered in a monastery at Balapitiya, a village between Colombo and Matara. In Sri Lanka is Ishvara, the name of God Shiva, as we know him from India. This is confirmed by his iconography. Four arms, keeping his weapon trident in one hand and a deer which seems to dance on the other hand. A snake hangs around his neck. The white bull Nandi is his vehicle. Ishvara is a less important deity in the monasteries of Sri Lanka. Usually he is placed on the top of the Makara Torana, which adorns the entrance to the sanctum. This is an early and rare depiction of Ishvara at the upper left corner of the entrance to the shrine of the Buddha. He is keeping two females with his two arms tied at his body. The elephant-headed god Ganesha, known from the family stories of Shiva, can also be discovered sometimes in small shrines in Sri Lanka. God Sakha or Shakra is well known from the Buddhist scriptures. He is also connected with the life of the Buddha and mentioned several times in the textual sources as the protector of the Buddha. His vehicle is the elephant since early Indian times, which are reflected in the Vedas. Here in the Vedas he is called Indra, Indra who is moving around on the rain-bringing elephant. There are only few paintings of Sakha in the monasteries of Sri Lanka. Sometimes his sculpture is placed on the top of the entrance to the Buddha's shrine. The four-faced Brahma is like Sakha or Chakra, a god which is already mentioned in Vedic sources. He appears also in the scriptures which tell the life of the Buddha. It was Brahma who invited him to be born in the world of humans in the city of Kapilavastu. His vehicle is a swan and he carries a parasol in hand. In Sinhala literature, Brahma is the chief god. Similar to Sakha, only few paintings of Brahma exist. Sometimes his sculpture is placed, together with that of Chakra, on the top of the entrance to the Buddha's shrine. Depictions of Maitri, the future Buddha, are often the subject of paintings in the monasteries in Sri Lanka. Maitri has usually the picture of a small sitting Buddha in his crown. Vishvakarman, the word means the one who can do different works, is very rarely depicted. He has 10 arms and 5 faces. He is always sent by Sakha or Chakra on all business of construction. He is the heavenly architect. To finish off, I added the paintings of 2 figures which can be seen around Matara in particular. Both are terrible aspects of God Shiva and probably of Dravidian origin. They guard the entrance to the temples and shrines. Shiva Agora has an elephant as vehicle. Shiva Vatuka is the one with the dog at his feet. There are further similar characters which are not identified so far. All of them are popular outside of the monasteries. They appear usually in the context of devil or demon dances, where they present specific characters. This is Shiva Agora. And this is Shiva Vatuka, who has a dog as a vehicle.